and I'm not going till you open this door. Kathy? Kathy!
Betty, oh. I don't want to see anybody.
I'll put the kettle on. Now, can I get you something to eat?
Betty, I'm not hungry. I haven't eaten or slept.
Well, that's only natural, love, but if I was you, I'd try and get 40 winks, cos you want to be looking your best when Biff comes back, don't you?
What?
I'm just surprised he's not here already.
Betty, you don't understand.
I think I do. You see, men are like this. Oh, they come on all brave and strong, but as soon as there's an emotional crisis, well, most of them just turn to jelly.
It's not Biff's fault. It's mine. I'm the one who's ruined everything.
Oh, don't be silly. You were standing there ready to do your bit. You didn't make him say no.
I think that's exactly what I did.
What do you mean?
Trust me, Betty, it's over. It's really over.
I'll be there as soon as I can.
I just want to get to the bottom of it.
Biff bottled out, that's all there is to it.
Mrs. Windsor?
Anyway, I'm off for a meeting with Gillian Winters at head office, and I reckon I'm in for a promotion.
Oh, good!
Mrs. Windsor, about that phone call.
I'll catch you later anyway. Trish?
Bye, love, and good luck. Now, what do you think of the wedding that wasn't?
Oh, poor Kathy. I hope someone's looking after her.
Oh, never mind poor Kathy. I want to know what's going on.
Eh?
Mrs. Windsor?
What?
I'd like to see my father this morning. The doctor says he's feeling much better.
Can't you see we're busy? Now, I reckon there's something we don't know about.
Thanks. Mind if I join you?
Of course not.
I'm afraid I'm still a bit shaken by events.
Hey, Luke, see Kathy?
I think it might be best if we gave her a bit of space.
I don't know. I reckon what she needs right now is a friend. I thought maybe you might be the right man to go and talk to her.
I don't think so.
Why not?
Be honest with me, Marlon. Do you think it could have been my fault?
No, I don't. What are you talking about?
I can't help wondering if what's happened is connected to Biff's jealousy of me.
I know it wasn't. Biff told me it wasn't.
Did he?
Made it completely clear. Listen, relationships can look perfect on the outside, but there can be all sorts of problems and complications behind closed doors.
True.
Bottom line, Graham, the only person who should be feeling guilty today is Biff.
I know. You're a good friend, Mo.
So go and see Kathy, yeah? She needs you.
Good morning, Miss Winters. How you doing?
So, Scott, how do you rate your progress with Think Tank so far?
On a scale of 1 to 10, I give myself 8, 8.5.
No higher?
I think I'm doing quite well, but there's always room for improvement.
Commendable. Does the name Harry Irving mean anything to you?
Yeah, he was a client, wasn't he? We lost him. He said to me that he was unhappy with the helpline service.
Not your fault, then. What about Sally Jackson at Vista Technology?
Same thing, I think. But with this business, you expect a bit of fluidity.
You might expect fluidity, but Think Tank expects loyalty. We contacted Mr. Irving and Miss Jackson and the other clients that you've lost. They all said they'd move to a brand new company called Dale Tech Computers. Does it ring a bell? Well, that's odd. Because when we investigated, we found that you'd set it up 3 months ago in direct competition with us. You've been stealing our clients almost from the day you arrived here. Oh, please. I don't want to hear another word from you. You're sacked, in case you haven't worked that out yet. And I'm going to make sure that everyone knows how you operate. The arrogance, the slick, superficial charm, the fundamental dishonesty. I give this new business of yours 6 months at the outside.
Coffee?
Yeah, thanks. So, have you seen Cathy yet?
No, I'm going round after work. I thought I'd allow a few hours for the dust to settle.
I'm not sure you should go round at all.
I'm sorry.
The last thing Cathy needs right now is you trying it on with her.
Zoe?
What? You mean it hadn't crossed your mind?
Cathy's one of the few people I care about. I don't like to see her hurt. I want to see if she's all right.
Sorry I spoke.
Where do you get off lecturing me while you're making a fool of yourself, chasing after Frankie?
I'm not making a fool of myself. I'm making progress.
He shouldn't be overexcited. He's still very weak.
I understand. Dad, how are you? Oh, you look well. You look much better. I've brought you bananas. Is it all right for him to eat bananas?
Please, Miss Wiley. Your father's not as strong as he looks. It'll be several weeks before he's well enough to leave the hospital.
But how do you feel?
Never mind me. How are you?
I'm very well, Dad. Very well indeed.
Oh, yeah? Why?
I'm going to tell you all my news. Have a banana.
No, he's just lost his nerve, that's all. I've told Cathy. He'll be back today, tail between his legs. He'll whisk her off on his bike and they'll get married on the quiet. It's the way men work. Simple creatures.
There's more to it than that. Did you two stop it?
You will not find a nicer or more straightforward man than Biff Fowler.
I'm telling you, there's something we don't know about. What?
We was just saying.
I know what you were doing.
I speak as I find.
Now, Luke, what you've done.
Well, some people just don't like to hear the truth.
There's always someone worse off than you.
Yeah. You know what this afternoon's got in store for me? Harvesting barley.
Fresh air, exercise.
No, don't!
All right, you said you'd come shopping with me. Let's do it today.
Oh, I shouldn't.
Oh, come on. A little bit of excitement.
People are going to talk about it. That's inevitable. But apart from poisonous gossips like Viv Windsor, they're on your side.
And that's just it. They shouldn't be on my side, should they?
We've been over this. It's too late to start feeling guilty now.
Biff didn't understand. Yes, I have some feelings for Graham, but nothing like what I feel for him.
Cathy, what are you talking about? This much feeling for Graham, this much feeling for Biff. Do you think that's how it works? You measure them, marry the one that comes out top?
If you don't mind, Laura, I want to be on my own.
Cathy.
It's very simple. Biff knew I loved him, I just didn't convince him I loved him enough. That's all there is to it.
I don't think you convinced yourself you loved him enough.
Hello, Maggie. Come to see Frankie.
I was, but I was hoping to see you too.
Well, here I am.
I want you to stay away from her.
It's a bit melodramatic, isn't it?
You probably think it's going to be easy, don't you? With your money and your pretty face, you probably think you can snap your fingers and Frankie'll come running.
Maggie. I think you're being a bit insecure.
I'm trying to stop you from embarrassing yourself. Me and Frankie are in love, Zoe, and I trust her completely. I'll tell you how close we are. Last week, Frankie got a tattoo. And do you know why? Because I've got one.
Funny, that's not the impression I got. You see, I decided to have one done. And then I dared her to have one too.
What?
Well, she did tell you I was with her, didn't she? No? I'm surprised she didn't mention it, you two being so close. Look, there's mine, same as hers. Lucky you trust her so completely, otherwise you might almost think that she had something to hide from you.
I worry about you. On your own at home.
You don't have to worry.
Of course I do. When you were little, I'd worry about you falling over and hurting yourself. When you're a bit older, I'd worry that you were lonely and you weren't getting a good education. And now, you're a young woman. A beautiful young woman. And there's other things to worry about.
What things?
Well, you don't know what men are like.
I do. Butch is kind and gentle.
Butch?
You know Butch's looking after me. He's been helping round the farm. And sleeping in the van outside the cottage.
He's been staying the night there. This has to stop.
Don't be silly. He's so kind. I wanted you to be pleased. Why are you pleased that he's looking after me?
I warned you about him. I won't have this.
You ought to be grateful to Butch. All he can do is be horrible about him. I think I better go.
What?
I'm going.
I am finished.
I'll come back tomorrow.
Emily, come back!
Oi, why did you lie to me?
What? What about?
About the tattoo. Why did you lie?
I didn't.
You told me you had a tattoo because I had one. You didn't tell me you and Zoe Tate skipped off and had it done together.
All right, Zoe were there, so what? I didn't think it were important.
She thinks it is. You embarrassed me. And you lied to me.
Maggie, you're letting Zoe wind you up over nothing.
I thought we were worth more than that.
I get bored with all the paperwork. It's not all chasing villains, you know.
Oh, you should see my paperwork when I do the accounts.
I'll swap you. I quite fancy working with animals.
Okay, it's a deal. I'll swap. No one will notice.
Are you coming out of there or what? Yeah, I like that.
Oh, yeah, so do I. Oh, but when will I ever wear it? I just can't justify it.
How does it make you feel?
Fabulous.
I'd say that justifies it.
Do you think Kathy will come in?
Oh, I very much doubt it.
You know what this village needs after the other day? A really successful wedding. A big event.
Yeah, thank you, Patricia.
If Stella hasn't given you her answer yet, it's about time you asked her.
Why did you do it?
Hello. What have I done?
Why did you tell Maggie we had the tattoos together?
Was I not supposed to?
You knew she'd be angry.
Frankie, I had no idea it was supposed to be a secret. We've got nothing to hide, have we? Look, join me. I'm having a late lunch. We'll talk about it.
I know what you're trying to do. It's not going to work.
Can I have another gin and tonic, please, Bernice?
Sure.
Stella, can I have a private word? You and Alan, isn't it about time you let them down gently?
Well, I was hoping he'd get the message without me having to say anything. I hate hurting people.
Oh, you've got a big heart, Stella.
Excuse me.
Go on. Now's your chance. She's on her own. Ask her if it's yes.
Will you kindly keep your voice down? I've asked Stella my question. I don't intend to hound her.
Grandad, if you don't get a move on, we're going to be homeless soon. Now, promise me you'll ask at the races tomorrow.
If it's your own welfare you're worried about, there's no need to be. I'll rent a little cottage somewhere and you can live with me.
I think I prefer home farm.
Well, that was fun. We should do it again.
Great. Let's make it a regular trip. Drink, champagne.
Or next time, maybe a club. I feel like a teenager. Oh, I thought you'd be out.
In the fields. I'm taking a break. Lunchtime drink went on a bit then.
Yeah, sorry. I meant to be back earlier.
Oh, never mind. I managed.
I went into Hotton with Angie.
Spending money we haven't got.
No, I was spending. Sarah was just watching.
Yeah, I was just tagging along.
Scott! Scott, get out here!
it.
What's the matter with you? Our car's just been nicked.
No, it's not. It's been repossessed. Think Tank found out about me stealing their clients and they gave me the sack.
You what? You said they gave you a pep talk.
Yeah, I couldn't handle telling my mum, all right?
No, it's not all right. You said you were using business contacts. You never said you were stealing clients.
Okay, so you know now.
Scott, we're not ready to make this work without support. You were going to invest your think tank income into it.
We'll manage.
No income, no contacts, and we'll manage. I don't believe this.
We're going to have to, all right? We're on our own now.
Hiya. But I've come all this way to talk to you. Don't give me the silent treatment.
What do you want to say?
You want me to apologise? I'm sorry. I'm sorry I didn't tell you Zoe was there when I had the tattoo done. I should have. I didn't want to turn it into an issue.
Well, that didn't work.
I should have been honest from the start, but the point is, it ain't a big deal to me.
Do you know what I said to Zoe? I said our relationship was all about trust.
Like not, Maggie. You know you can trust me. It's nice having Zoe hanging around and okay, she's fun to be with, but I love you. You know that, don't you? Maggie.
Yeah, I know. But I think Zoe needs to be told. I think someone needs to make it really crystal clear to her.
So I just said to him, I'll come back tomorrow. And I walked out.
Good for you.
Never spoken to him like that before.
Well, it's about time that you did. Right, I'll be in van.
Okay. Unless you want to.
I'd like that.
What?
Oh, weren't you going to ask me in?
Yeah.
Well, that. I'd like that.
Okay. Only you'll sleep on the sofa and you can't come upstairs.
Why? What's upstairs?
Never mind. Come in.
I presume you intend to gloat?
No. I'm here to see if you're all right.
I'm fine.
No, you're not. Why wouldn't Biff go through with it?
It's none of your business, Chris. You just want to say I told you so.
No, I'm guessing that he worked out that you don't love him.
What are you wrong?
I know he loved you. The only reason he'd have turned you down is if you don't feel the same way.
I love him, and marrying him would have worked.
Just doesn't quite ring true.
Oh, shut up, will you?
All right, I'm sorry. I don't want to make you feel bad, but you know I don't really do tact.
Just go away, Chris. I don't really want to see anybody.
Well, that's going to be difficult.
He's always looked after me. Arranged me life.
But, Emily, you're too old to have someone arranging your life for you.
That's what happens, isn't it? Your parents care for you. Then slowly, after a while, you start looking after them.
You can't see me looking after my dad.
Not yet. But one day, especially if there's no Lisa. You see, I thought that were my future. Staying with my dad as he got older. Always looking after him.
But that's not right.
He used to read me bedtime stories. There were one with a handsome prince in it. Prince Al. I used to have this dream. That Prince Al would ride up to the door, sweep me up, and take me away.
Did he look like me?
No. And once he'd done sofa and said, that's not right.
So you're still looking for him then?
No.
Why not?
Because I found someone much better.
Well, I can see him having second thoughts. I just don't see why they had to be at the altar.
Well, it's a mystery to me what goes on in men's heads. What you got there, Tricia?
Oh, it's a brochure all about ploughmans. You read it. I hope you're going to enjoy working for them.
Don't be too hard on her, Gavin. Poor girl's going to be in pieces when Stella turns down her granddad.
Those of the real world might do her some good.
Mm. Still was in a state herself earlier. She was acting really funny. I'm sure it's because she couldn't bear to face Alan.
All I'm saying is that we should dig a bit deeper.
You said this morning. What are you on about?
Well, I want to know why it happened, that's all.
Why it happened concerns just Beth and Kathy. It's got nought to do with anyone else.
I think this is one occasion you'd be well advised to keep your thoughts to yourself.
So how are you going to pay her back now, Scott? I'm not going to. Ron never get his act together to buy a house in a million years.
Our offer's been accepted, so we just need a deposit now.
Oh, well done, girl. Hey, do you know, this reminds me of when I got my first dog.
Yeah, that's pretty. So, can I have the money?
Well, there's more to it than that, Kelly. I mean, you have to wait for the mortgage to be agreed and all the legal stuff.
Yeah, whatever. But we should have the money ready.
It is ready. It's in the bank.
Oh, this is so exciting. I feel like a new life starting.
Who's that?
Who's there?
It's all right. It's
Mr. Wiley. Get out.
God, you should be in hospital.
He's why I'm not.
The doctor said weeks. You shouldn't be out for weeks. You'll make yourself ill.
Shut up. You out. I'm not going, Mr. Wiley. What? I'm not going. Emily's a grown-up. She's not a little girl anymore. She can make her own mind up.
Both of you, stop this.
You don't know what's best for her.
I'm her father.
Well, I love her.
Emily, tell him to go. You may have her full, but I know what you're after. Get off my land.
No.
Dad!
I've done nothing wrong, Mr. Wiley. I love Emily, and she loves me.
No, Dad, he's got it wrong. Don't try and speak. It's all right, he's got it wrong.
Emily!
Just do as he says, go away! I've got to help him, Butch, look at him. Go away. It's all right. All right, Dad. I'm here.
Yes?
Kathy, how are you?
Just go away.
Wait. I think you need some company.
Don't tell me what I need.
I want to help.
Well, you can't. I'd be married right now if it wasn't for you. You've ruined my life.
Kathy.
Just go away, Graham.
Did she just slam the door in your face?
I'm afraid so.
It's not a good time to be talking to her.
Of course, it's too soon. She's bound to be upset.
I'll just leave her for a while. I think she's confused right now.
A good friend isn't that easily put off. She was there for me when I needed her, and I intend to be there for her. I'm not going to give up on her.